Rembrandt Harmens van Rijn, the great Dutch artist who lived from 1606 to 1669, established himself as a portrait painter with cherished paintings such as The Anatomy Lesson of Dr. Look and The Night Watch. This great painter is distinguished from the rest in many ways, and we will look at his three most striking uniqueness, his countless self-portraits, his etchings, and his famous works. The number of times Rembrandt painted himself is still a matter of contention, but it seems there are approximately 40 to 50 paintings, about 32 etchings, and 7 drawings. Rembrandt is an anomaly in the history of artists' self-portraits, as most artists only produce a handful of them. Why did Rembrandt paint so many self-portraits? This is probably one of the greatest mysteries in art history. It is generally agreed upon that Rembrandt's collection of self-portraits was a sort of visual diary, a 40-year exercise in self-examination. Art historian Manuel Gesser mentioned in 1961 that, over the years, Rembrandt's self-portraits increasingly became a means for gaining self-knowledge, and in the end took the form of an interior dialogue of a lonely old man communicating with himself. Rembrandt's late self-portraits changed its focus from exploration of art techniques to exploration of his own life and soul, a form of self-reflection. In the 17th century, there was an avid market for paintings in which the model plays a role or expresses a particular emotion. Thus, for example, we have four tiny etchings from 1630 that show Rembrandt, in turn, caught fearful surprise, glowering with anger, smiling gamefully, and appearing to snarl, each expressed in lines that themselves embody the distinct emotions. Rembrandt may have used his own face because the model was cheap, but the art-buying public was also interested in portraits of famous people including artists, so he was also making himself into a recognizable celebrity at the same time. That served to establish his reputation as an artist.
Many people are surprised to learn that Rembrandt's etchings, not his paintings, were responsible for the international reputation he enjoyed during his lifetime. For the Europeans of that time, Rembrandt's etchings gave them aesthetic enjoyment, and also satisfied their curiosity about distant plaque, about distant places and people. It was, other than the printed word itself, the 17th century's major means of mass communication. Publishers, and artists themselves, issued and circulated quantities of prints. Some took the form of simple broadsheets, others illustrated books, others reproduced, privately owned paintings inaccessible to public view. Gus Rembrandt's fame while he lived was greater as an etcher than as a painter. The acknowledged master of the medium, he turned it into a wondrously flexible instrument of his art. Biblical themes, genre, landscapes, portraits, nudes are all themes he found suitable for etching. He was so superb an etcher that critics were persuaded that he had discovered a secret process. Within 2 or 3 years after his first efforts, Rembrandt had become a master of etching. The twin currents of refinement and dash, of the smooth and the rough, emerge in Rembrandt's work from the very beginning, and are by no means contradictory. They indicate instead the tremendous range of a young man, who was able to accomplish more in a few years than many other artists achieves in a lifetime. Till date, at least 79 of Rembrandt's original plates are still in existence.
Rembrandt completed the painting of the militia company of Captain Franz Banninkoff in 1642. This painting was called the Night Watch upon its discovery because the painting lacks lighting, thus causing it to appear dim and seem defaced by time, such that it was almost indistinguishable and it looked rather similar to a night scene. However, it was realized that this painting is meant to represent broad day. More specifically, it is a group portrait of a company of civil guards under the command of Koch and his lieutenant Willem van Rijn. When the critics and the public attached the term night watch to the painting, the canvas had become so darkened by dirt and layers of varnish that it was difficult to tell whether the illumination Rembrandt had provided it came from the sun or moon. Not until after the end of World War II was the painting fully restored so that the viewer could get an idea of the brightness it had when it left Rembrandt's hand more than 300 years before. The fact that some members of the company are partially obscured by the action did not cause the work to be condemned, as has been suggested. In this painting, Rembrandt solved the problem of the group portrait in such a dynamic way that few after him could ever again sit or stand their subjects in a static line or static Rembrandt shields cocked and his men in motion. Their lances are askew, their muskets are out of order, and they all project a sense of the vitality of their mission. In this group portrait, Rembrandt captures the personality of the entire company